Ambassador of the United States to the Philippines, Ambassador Mary Kay Carlson, East-West Center President Ms. Suzanne Baris-Lim, friends in both the local and foreign media, good morning to you all. It is indeed a great honor for me to keynote this year's International Media Conference. It's also an honor for the Philippines, where press freedom is constitutionally guaranteed, to host it for the very first time. And also allow me to thank the East-West Center for choosing the Philippines as host and for organizing this wonderful conference. Our gathering could not have come at a more crucial time. The ability of the press to report on global events and the ability of people to appreciate and understand these events is under sustained attack from disinformation and cyber attacks. Many countries, including the Philippines, have been targeted by malign actors wantonly exploiting technology to distort and manipulate facts. As such, so-called, quote, alternate realities drown out the truth and adversely affect the public discourse. Amidst all this, the Philippine government has been working hand-in-hand with the media to ensure that the public possesses the facts. These efforts form an essential part of our commitment to a rules-based international order and our determination to protect and preserve our sovereignty, our sovereign rights, and jurisdiction, especially in the West Philippine Sea. Genuine photos and videos, or those that are not AI-generated or digitally manipulated, speak louder and more powerfully than the myriad attempts at misinformation and the peddling of false narratives. Our friends in the media, and many of you present here today, have been able to report on these developments freely without force and intimidation from a government. A free press reporting on events as they are is the hallmark of a true democracy. And we are grateful for our partnership with you. Your work has helped to put the spotlight on what is really happening in the West Philippine Sea. And your reporting has highlighted our country's efforts to push back against illegal, coercive, aggressive, and deceptive actions in our own waters. For far too long, the narrative surrounding the West Philippine Sea has been obscured by disinformation, coupled with attacks against our government's IT infrastructure. One such false narrative paints the West Philippine Sea as merely a stage for great power rivalry in the region, that the Philippines is merely a pawn in the new great game. This reductionist view muddles our understanding of the complex situation on the ground or the sea, and detracts from the real crux of the issue, that a country is choosing to ignore or is reinterpreting international law, in particularly the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea, and as affirmed by the 2016 Arbitral Award, and hence the legitimate rights and interests of coastal states, such as the Philippines, are affected. Only faithful implementation of the rules in the maritime space can effectively reduce conflict over maritime boundaries and resource claims, thereby promoting peace and stability at sea. President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. has repeatedly underscored the Philippines' adherence to an open, inclusive, and rules-based international order that is governed by international law and informed by the principles of equity and justice. We have championed a consistent position. Maritime claims in the South China Sea cannot go beyond the UNCLOS. No country can claim almost the entirety of the South China Sea as its territory and use such claim to justify illegal and dangerous actions in waters over which we have sovereignty, sovereign rights, and jurisdiction. Many of you have witnessed for yourselves the harassment and intimidation our people have faced. Many of you have also reported on how our people have been blocked from their legitimate sources of livelihood. Our transparency initiative in the West Philippine Sea is just one of several approaches that we have been implementing, but is a key component that has significantly contributed to the public's awareness of the situation. For this, we have all of you to thank, our media partners. We have also been working with our allies and partners in the international community who value and share the same respect for upholding the truth. The United States counts among our essential partners in proactively helping us address these challenges. Our two countries share the same vision for a free and open Indo-Pacific, characterized by a rules-based governance of our global commons. And the Philippines and the United States are set to work together against misinformation and are discussing a possible memorandum of cooperation on countering foreign information manipulation. We are holding for the very first time the Philippines-United States Cyber Dialogue next month. Technology, as we all know, is a double-edged sword, and we must maximize its benefits while preventing its abuses. From a regional perspective, the ASEAN 2035 Vision Statement, issued by the ASEAN ministers responsible for information, recognized a paradigm shift in the use of information. The vision statement called on cooperation in enhancing information accessibility and digital innovation in order to provide the media sector the means to address the transformative changes brought about by our digital age. And ASEAN is fully cognizant that the rapid digitalization of communication platforms has invariably led to the uptick of fake news, digital hate, and extremist views, which severely degrade public discourse, fuel distrust, and undermines the effective functioning of a free press. In this regard, the ASEAN leaders have tasked our senior officials responsible for information to, among others, develop and execute sustainable and future-proof strategies that adapt to and leverage digital transformation, implement evidence-based strategic communications plans, mechanisms, tools, and best practices to help continue delivering accurate and timely information to citizens, and to pursue strategic collaboration as well as leverage the transformative power of media in nature and nurture a culture of critical thinking and lifelong learning. We remain hopeful that through these efforts, our citizens will be better equipped in navigating the rapidly changing information and media landscape. Our ASEAN senior officials were also tasked to mainstream the role of information and media sector to support a whole of ASEAN response to emerging global challenges such as disaster management, climate change and environmental concerns, health emergencies, and cybersecurity. The Philippines will be leading an ASEAN forum on raising media and information literacy in the age of artificial intelligence. This will be a gathering of government, academe, and media representatives from all the ASEAN member states to discuss strategies to promote media and information literacy in an AI-driven information landscape. We will also organize an ASEAN symposium on enhancing access to public information, which will present a platform for stock-taking and sharing of best practices in terms of access to information programs in ASEAN member states. And on the part of the public sector, ASEAN has also developed an ASEAN guideline on management of government information in combating fake news and disinformation in the media. This attests to ASEAN's commitment to providing a safer and more informed digital space for all. Friends, social media and AI have revolutionized the way people create, share, and consume information. They democratize information and give everyone a voice in the public discourse. They are powerful tools and hold great potential to benefit our societies. But social media and AI have also been used by both state and non-state actors to attack the democratic institutions which these technologies were meant to support and to enhance. In this age where people are targeted by an unrelenting stream of unverified, inaccurate, and misleading information peddled on social media, the role of the press and its partnership with government in ensuring that the public is well informed about the issues becomes even more critical. As such, the Philippines truly believes the media has a key role to play, not only in informing or entertaining, but also in shaping public opinion, challenging societal norms, and fostering meaningful dialogue. I know it is a gargantuan task indeed, but as I look around this room and see all of the best journalists and media personalities gathered, I'm confident this challenge will be addressed effectively. And you may also rest assured that we in the Philippine government are your partners in this endeavor. Thank you.